Bari ban sani sai kun dai nin ma no ban dai safin ji.
Kilo le bota.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam ba.
Eh bare.
Wa ko do ki yana ne yuna ya mun.
Mi to yuna. Man sara. Yuru na dalal. Ya ji.
Yelo na dal.
Ngama no sammanan ngatlo sam Bismillah
na na ñu manu di atal ko
yalla ñu manu wara demé yona biro ngay taawla nga ta ko do kama dem man façon fula wala biñe kilo tal lul tabeje kilo moni lul tabeje hani duuli no beje ni tetale ko do kam ni lefta ko do le sko do ta inaita la dia te fene si manul sanjani tulon ni hani ni fo ngoni alkame to wabul kame fo kan dirin kleme ni lemna to nga bon de je
yuna la ka ñu be sama
na tu la ka ñu be sama na yaaje
Stewart and Co. Solicitors, a legal excellence firm in London that can help you with all aspects of your legal work. If you are looking at immigrating to the United Kingdom, Stewart and Co. can help you to set up business, buy houses in the UK, and will deal with all your legal works from start to finish.
For all your general immigration work, we can help you with that as well. If you apply for any form of visa, whether student visas, settlement visas, marriage visas, or a child wanting to come to the United Kingdom to settle with the family, we can help you to achieve your goals.
Stewart & Co. Solicitors, a legal excellence firm specializing in conveyancing, immigration, litigation, family law, personal injury, licensing, no win, no fee. Contact us today at www.sk-solicitors.com.
Yaran yin la domoro kadiyatel
boy jannon secret restaurant
sai nakko be ni na dimbal nimbe domoro kala janno
domoro seneata adiata topotoro fanan kende ma bije luntan during tamala abbe ka domoro ki janni adi manda wala de teka we bijele anim fanan ka fadi jang ikono e fa e ka fa minna ko pastry anim bakery iko fanan be kalele badde lomba conference lomba workshop lomba ye fo fendi lon dunya kono domoro betama ñillom international otoda number 1
amanke ba do mala jang dama
e sa do mo jang is ataria
ah wo mu ku bandi
sa nakko sa futandin
e oto sa nakko be mu CKS restaurant
ndaba non janno mu yak ni manje do rombi jang
aban
CKS restaurant known for best quality food.
So please proceed.
Yes, Mr. Chair, we ready to witness is being ushered in. Thank you.
Thank you.
Welcome back, Mr. Job.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Mr. Job, ñu la dalalat.
Thank you all.
Before the break,
balañ doon dem ci break bi,
you told us about two important events or incidents that occurred in your life.
Wax nga ñu ñaari xew xew yo xamne lu am solo la ci sa dunda.
The first was your arrest and torture during the when the UDP intended to hold a rally at Fitzgerald Street in 2002.
Bu ñëk ba modi mitital bi nga xamné def nañ la ko jamono ji nga xamé né way UDP ñu doon faso def rally bo xamné ñu ko doon bëgga def ci Fitzgerald Street ci Banjul.
On the second one you talked about was your arrest by NIA officers during which you were taken to the NIA, tortured, electrocuted on your private parts, resulting in your loss of manhood and being made to lie on cold floor, as a result of which you suffered chronic pneumonia.
Benen bi moy biñ la jappé yobula NIA def la fa ay mitital yu bari yo xamné jël nañ courant di la ko def ci sa yaram bi be taxna sax nga ñak sa goria akit ay mi gañu ci bari yo xamné am nga ko ci sa yaram bi ci jamono joju nga xamné ñu ngi la jëlone yobul la fofu ci NIA.
And finally you were detained at the NIA for 2 months, after which you were transferred to the remand wing of Mile 2 prisons and released soon after.
Ganaw bi nak ñu jëlé la NIA yobula remind fofu ci mile 2 di re ñaari wër yo xamné ya nga fofu ganaw gi nak ci lañ la doora bayyi.
And you were never taken before any court.
Té nak musuñ la yobbu ci court.
Now let's proceed with your testimony.
Légui nak ñu égalé sa CD yi.
Your arrest, detention, torture of 2011 was not the last time you had an encounter with the security forces of this country, correct?
Arrest bin la arreston jappala def la ay mitital yo yef ci atum 2011 emul fofu rek de amna yenen yo xamne xewat na du lol
degala.
Tell us about the incident in April 2016.
Wax ñu bi nga xamne nak mo xewon wéri April ci atum 2016.
Thank you very much, Council. Jerejef.
Thank you.
April 2016 bu Westfield la xewon incident bu.
That incident happened at the Westfield.
Time bu ñu executive bi digé nak from Ker Ousseynou pour head about ñu to Westfield.
It was when the executive left Ousseynou's compound heading to the Westfield.
Mr. Witness, let's give a bit of background to this. Did anything happen on 14th or 15th April 2016 concerning the UDP party?
Ñu wax rek japp bes bi moy fukki fan at ñeneen ak fukki fan ak juroom ci wéru April 2016 ndax dara xewon na
ci parti UDP
ci parti UDP bi
aw
Yes, something happened.
Could you tell us about it?
Incident Westfield.
That incident happened at the Westfield.
What was it about?
That was when the UDP executive came out from Usenu's compound.
Westfield.
Coming towards Westfield.
What were they coming to do?
Political reform.
They were coming for a political reform.
How were they doing that?
Naka lañ ko doon defé?
A group. Ñu dajé kër Ousseynou.
A group met at Ousseynou's compound.
So fofu lañ assemblé géna.
That was where they assembled and came out.
Was it just a simple procession or was it a protest?
Lolu mom dajé la won rek bo len don def di dem wala dafa amone lo len don ñaxtu.
Waaw dafa duñ don ñaxtu.
It was a protest.
Tell us about it.
Parce que affaire sañu carte bi ñum don démé jamono joju.
It was in relation to the elections, the way it was taking place in those days.
Waaw lolu lañ don xex.
That was what they were fighting.
That's why mota gaay gëna.
That was why they came out.
Duguer Ousseynou pour voir de Westfield Johnson.
Left Ousseynou's compound towards the Westfield Junction.
Ñoo be commune.
Was there an earlier demonstration prior to this one you are talking about?
Da mon na ben ñaxtu bo xamne amone na lu jitu bi nga wax ni.
No man bi bi la tombé won.
This was the one I took part in.
We understand this is the one you witnessed and participated in. But was there any earlier demonstration that day or the days preceding, the days prior to that?
Hamnen ne bi nga fekke won te bi nga bokkon waye ndax amone na benen bo xamne hewon na ay fan bala bi
wa mo ñu solo senjeng late solo.
Yes, this is the one concerning the late solo Sandeng and the others
at Bamboo Night Club Johnson Safidin,
or the Bamboo Night Club Johnson in Safidin.
And what was that about?
Bobu mom lan la won
bobu tamit solo mo gena ak gayami pour affaire political reform bi ñomi di same problème la won.
Solo came out with his colleagues on political reforms.
Mom mo ñëk gena bo la ñu Ousseynou.
He came out before Ousseynou.
And do you know what happened to the demonstration that was led by Solo Sandeng?
Xamone nga li xewon ci ñaxtu bobu nga xamne Solo Sandeng moko jité won.
Waaw bu affaire moy affaire political reform bi rek di
sen
defin la rek political reform bi la won rek di sen la won.
It's the same political reform.
Listen to the question carefully. Do you know what happened to Solo Sandeng during that demonstration that he led?
They are 9 in numbers, dal.
The NIA, you knew for certain. You are telling us that Solo Sandeng was arrested around Bambo, and you two were subsequently arrested and taken to the NIA.
Wan melni dag ñoo bëgga wax ne Solo Sandeng dañ ko arreston ci boori Bambo gannaaw lolu tam.
Westfield.
Ci boss Westfield now.
As was at Westfield.
The demo. On the same day or different dates?
different business. For the business, why not?
First,
in a sense,
at around Bamboo in London corner. Mm-hmm.
Wow. Mu melni solo sanding dafa jité won ñaxtu bi ngir doon ñaxtu nak ay soppal yo xamne dañ ko wara def ci wali election bi. Mu xewé won nak ci Bamboo. Non la
dewe.
As far as you know, was he arrested on the day of that demonstration or on a different date?
Ci yow li nga xam bes bobu mu doon def ñaxtu bi ci lañ ko japp wala benen bes dañ ko jàngoon.
Mo mune fatale ko fogna that very day dañ ko tié.
If I recall well, I think it was the very day that he was arrested.
Do you know what was the exact reason why the executive of the UDP had to come out and make their own demonstration?
Lan mo waralon kilifa yi nga xamne ñom ñoo jité UDP ñu genn pour di def ñaxtu yu mel nonu?
Ñaxtu bobu moy bay tie solo.
That protest was after they arrested Solo.
Usenu related Solo dead or alive?
Usenu was demanding for Solo either dead or alive.
So lolu bokana ci lita executive bi gina.
That was one of the reasons why the executive came out.
Ak political reform bi tam yep ci la bokka.
And also the political reform too was also part of it.
Let's try to understand what you're saying. You're suggesting that the executive of the UDP also made a demonstration during which they demanded that Solo Sandeng be handed over to them dead or alive. That's what you say?
Yes.
Wa ñu leral fofu rek yow li nga bëgg wax ni moy ne ñi nga xamne ñom ñoy jiti UDP bi ñom dañu gennon ganna bo xamé né ñu ngi jappon solo ñom nak ñu genn di laccé né ñom solo lañ soxla mo xam mu dunda wala mu dé dal dañ soxla solo.
That's true.
That was the demonstration in which you participated, correct?
Bobu moy ñaxtu bi nga xamné yow mi ci nga bokko.
Wow, bu executive bi di gënal non.
Yes, the one in which the executive came out.
Could you tell us about that demonstration and your role in it?
Di ñu mëna wax mbiri ñaxtu bobu naka la démé ak yow mi lan mo ci won sa taxaway?
Man dama joggé Banjul.
I came from Banjul.
In fact, meeting the executive was on the way they are coming to Westfield.
In fact, I did not meet the executive on their way coming to Westfield. I was standing by the Nawek Junction.
With a group of people that I
met With thousands of people.
Nawek Junction where?
In, you know, cooperative Fufu.
By the cooperative.
Fufu Ling Tao.
That was where we stood. That was where I stood.
So you have information.
How did you know that something was going to happen on that day?
Naka nga xamé né amna lu warona xew bes bobu?
Ba mon ci parti bi la bokal li xew dama ko li wara am dama ko day yek.
I am a party member of the party, and if anything is to happen, I'm always informed.
Amon na li dina lu wara xew.
I knew that that was going to happen.
So man mo dem taw fala nekkon.
So I went and stood. I was there.
Information they intercepted me around Communion Johnson, Kairaba Avenue.
I got information that they were intercepted around the Communion Junction by the
PIU officers.
By the Kairaba Avenue, by PIU officers.
Who was intercepted?
Executive.
The executive, Usainu and the others. Mm.
Perhaps you should wait for the interpretation. Mm. Thank you. Who was intercepted?
Can more lane get and won?
Usainu and the executive.
Usainu and the executive.
And what happened during that process?
Lan mo xew nak ci jamono bobu?
Dañ len arrest.
They arrested them.
Dugal len ci truck.
Boarded them on a truck.
Who arrested them?
Kan mo len arrest?
PIU officers.
The PIU officers.
How many of them were arrested, if you know?
Ñaata ci ñoom lañ arreston budé xam nga ko?
Executive bi lañ arreston. Ñi gënon ñepp.
The entire executive was arrested, those that came out.
Bem des kena.
Except one.
Aji Sware.
Aji Sware.
Jabari Dembo by force.
The wife of Dembo by force.
So hole natal bi sa munchi munchi.
If you look at the photograph, she was there.
Mufa.
She was there.
Why mom rek mo ci miss.
But she was the only one missing.
Dafa lucky trop.
She was very lucky.
Ni ko def ci don bokki.
Otherwise, she would have been.
Wa ñi fa nek ñep lañ tey.
But all those that were there were arrested.
Ñom Kemi Sen Jame, ñom Femi Pitas.
People like Kemi Sen Jame, Femi Pitas.
Deputy Speaker.
The Deputy Speaker.
Ñom ñep.
All of them.
And but you were not at the scene of arrest. You were at Cooperative Union End.
Yow nekulo won ci bere ba nga xamne fa lañ leen doon arresté. Yow yaangi won ci boori cooperative nonu.
Wow.
Yes. So how did you come to know of this arrest?
Naka nga xamé mbiri arrest bi?
Parce que dafa ñu fa joggé.
Those that came from there.
Our party militants lañ.
Where our party militants?
Ñu information bi.
They came and gave us the information.
And what was the information you received?
Ban hibar lañ la jox.
Ñu ñu téne executive bi yépp ñu Ousseynou gaay yépp ñu gënou ñépp téne ñu leen.
They told us that they arrested the whole executive, those that came out, Ousseynou and the others, all of them were arrested.
Même des Aji Soare.
Except Aji Soare.
And how did you feel when you had that information?
Ba nga déggé hibar bobu nak yow lo yek.
I was very shocked. Na yar na ma torop.
It pained me a lot.
Mamadi torop.
It pained me a lot.
Parce que ni ci lañu déggé sen right la.
Because what they came out for was their right.
Political reform is for everybody.
And the political reform was for everybody.
It's for the Gambia. Lolu motay Yaya Jame, lolu sax bokkali ta Yaya Jame gene fi.
That was one of the reasons why Yaya Jame left this place.
So having had that information that the party you supported, the leadership was arrested, what did you do next?
Bi nga joté xibar bobu nak na yo parti bi nga xamné ñom nga faral sen kilifa yeb arrest nañ len lo def
ñu dañ don paré jogé fofu Nawek Johnson pour dem di wo Kairaba Avenue.
We were about to leave the Nawek Johnson to head on to the Kairaba Avenue.
Before ñuy paré départ,
before we departed,
military truck bi ñu,
a military truck arrived.
You said we who are you referring to when you said we?
Ñu bari la
né ñun so né ñun la yeen ñan la
ñu bari la woon
ñu ñu mëne.
As far as you know,
of course, sir.
Ni nga wax ni ñep ndax UDP lañ waxon.
Yes,
party militants lay.
They were party militants
and they headed towards Westfield.
Ñi ngi jublu won Westfield.
And then what happened?
Lana xew ganaw bobu
fuul Westfield before ñu dégué fa.
Before we left there,
ñu wara ko sila military truck bi arrive.
As I told you, it was when the military truck arrived.
Am ñu dégué PIU Kanifin fofu.
Some came from the PIU in Kanifin there.
PIU officers lay ñoomit.
Those were PIU officers.
Am seen batin yes and helmeti.
They had their batins and their helmets.
No attack the crowd bi.
They came and attacked the crowd.
To the military truck bi action avait paré.
At that time the military truck had already arrived.
Fofu la gay dooré di jom suñ kaw.
That was when they started jumping on us.
With their life round.
With their life rounds, he said.
Yeah.
Accent Bali Fetali.
Who are you referring to when you said they started jumping on us?
Ñan nga wax ni bo waxé né dañ commencé di top ci sen ko.
Ay soldar lay.
They were soldiers.
So when jumpé ci ko ci palu sun kaw.
So when they jumped on us,
am na commencé habé nak.
There was one person recognized.
You go away, how much something son? He was in the Navy.
They called him something son. Eh? He was in the Navy.
What could that guy, the guy who shot Fafa Nyang?
That was the guy who shot Fafa Nyang.
How do you know that he was the guy that shot Fafa Nyang?
I'm not going to have any more fatal Fafa Nyang.
I watched you and him as he testified here.
Do you know his name?
I'm going to turam.
Wow, I'm not turam. I'm not landing home and lamin something like that. Fadina turam.
Yes.
It was in the Navy.
I knew his name. Is it a lamin or landing son? But okay. He was in the Navy.
Are you sure about the surname?
Ndax santa bi non la
wa something la sama mistake gu dal lu la nek dal ina man mo fi fatte turam way man hamé nako personally
something like that. Maybe I forgot his name but I can recognize him.
Can you describe him?
Mun nga ñoo wax naka la mel
wa wa yu am taxaway la rek.
Is well built
taw par ñool cook
and is
black color.
Is dark in complexion
from red beret.
He used to put on a red beret.
Tall or medium height or short?
Almost my height. If he would be taller than me, it would just be a little bit, but we should be of the same height.
I would give you a few names and you tell us which one is correct. Lamin Sise, Lamin Koli, Lamin Jamme, Landing Jamme, Lamin Landing Sise, which one?
It's Lamin Koli.
I brought a newspaper here when I came to give my statement.
It was a poor newspaper.
So, how do you know it is Lamin Koli?
Because it's in the Navy at the seaport.
Because it was in the Navy at the seaport.
So neighbors, like every time we were volunteering them.
They were our neighbors and we were interacting with them all the time.
Did you know him personally or you merely recognized him?
Xam nga ko mom ci bopam ni ndax dang ko xamé rek.
Wa xawma ko nak.
I don't know him.
Wa xamé na dama ko xamé rek.
But I recognized him.
But do you realize that Lamin Koli is in fact not as tall as you? You are perhaps way taller than him, if I may put it that way.
It can be possible. You know, it's just a description, but it can be possible.
But you are right anyway.
But and Lamin Koli was a medic.
Lamin Koli mom fajj kat la won.
Yes, it could be because the Navy also have military doctors.
But how do you know that the person you had an encounter with is called Lamin Koli?
Because in the crowd there were some who knew him and they were calling his name.
But how do you know that he testified before the TRRC?
Naka nga xamé né ñew na fi ci kanam TRRC?
Ko gis ci télé bi ya mom.
I saw him over television with you.
Yeah.
Well, would it surprise you to note that I did not lead him in evidence? He was led by my colleague Maria Masingate.
Wa xam nga né Lamin Koli mom kiko don laaj fi du won man dé Maria Masingate la.
Ba tay rek gën ñu fa nekkon ci table bi dal anyway.
All the same, all of you were on the desk.
Anyway, I would not make a mistake. Why any phone you can keep panel be anyway?
It could be a mistake, but all of you were there.
In fact, on that occasion I was hardly on the table that day. I spent most of the time outside.
But you're still.
Are you convinced positively that the person, the soldier you saw there on that day, was Lamin Koli?
Ndax orna la nak ne yow soldar bi nga gisone bes bobu Lamin Koli momu la.
Parce que momo gañ.
He wounded me.
How did he wound you?
Naka la la gagné?
Oui. Fetel la ma dour, pas de fetel.
He hit me with the gun butt.
Har suma djebi. Ma dalu. Fi ay officer ci ñu
tore my forehead and I fell down. Can you give us a blow by blow rundown of how that happened? Step by step, what happened?
Di ñu mëna waxal rek nanka ndank lan moy li nga xamne mo xew ben ben. Li xewon bes bobu jël ko jéego pour jéego ci ko nonu nanka nanka.
Proceed please.
Ki ñoom bu ñëwé Westfield ak military truck bi.
Because when they came to the Westfield in their military truck,
they jumped suñ kaw
and they jumped on us.
Na mo bom jumpé man la jakkaro ya.
When he jumped, he faced me.
Mu door ma fetel ma daan.
He hit me with a gun and I fell down.
PI officers yi bokk ci.
The PI officers were involved.
Door ma daan ci pax bobu nekk nawek.
They beat me up and I fell into the dish by nawek.
Moy pax bu reey bobu nekk fofu.
That's the big dish there.
Fekk ma fa di ma stamp.
They came after me there and they were stamping on me.
La ñaka suma bo ñi yep.
That was where I lost my teeth.
Lost my eyesight. Bet legi.
I lost my eyesight till date.
Es fo bouti fo la yaho.
All my eyes were spoiled from there.
And don't case mo bi ko difin ci photo bi.
They held my head and they were smashing it against the muddy water.
You said you lost all your teeth.
Ngane da nga ñaka sa bo ñi
dem na.
All of them are gone.
Your smile seems to suggest that there are still some.
Ni nga muñe nak nuru na ne amna bo ñu fa
ci kaw. Wa ci yeb mom kanam yeb dem na
on top but all the front ones are gone
après suñ la tié dila ékaté di dor sap ko fami ci bir photo
because if they held your head and they keep smashing it against the mud
no but yeb mom la yaw
my eyes that was how they all got spoiled
so the mud entered your eyes
photo bi dafa duggal sa bouti
wow
yes
souf
sand
lu neka
everything
da goudi sa douma de gis
which is why in the night I can't see
ma solo lunette douma gis
if I don't put on my spectacles I can't see
kay sa smoko tie douma re mouna gis
if I hold a paper I am unable to see
and after all that beating did they leave you behind
ganna buñ la doré dor yoy yep nak ndax ci lañ bayyi nañ la gannaaw
wa fa lañ ñu bayyi parce que xam nga crowd baangi bari
yes that was where they left us because there was a huge crowd
ñu seen opinion ñu pour dor ñu daanu suñ kaw
and their opinion was just to come and beat us up and
am nañu xam ni tiyé nañ len
be aggressive towards us but there were some that we arrested
ñu bari
many
ñu la rushé crowd bi
that was how I sneaked out of the crowd
mo duga dikanté jacaranda
I went between jacaranda that way
non la escape
that was how I escaped
how were you able to see
naka nga defo nak be muna gis
I was blind I was blind non mo non try ba magi bisuma boti way xamna fi ma ja ino place ma jar no cross tali su fego do mo so do ñu sa fa don ray
I tried and opened my eyes and crossed the road and if I told a vehicle was coming it was going to kill me
mo face me put a long time go
the whole of my face was covered in mud
mangé bleed
mangé
was
bleeding
okay
I was bleeding and then what did you do after passing through jacaranda
légui lo def nak gannaaw bo jaaré nonu romba jacaranda
dama dug kanifing
I went into kanifing
mo jaar ci yoni gannaaw bi
I took the back way
mo jaar ci back way bi ci gannaaw
through the back
and then what happened
after fufula dohe be banjul
that's where I walked up to banjul
me mo try pour mo dem ci l'hôpital bi
I tried and got to the hospital
mo demé ci l'hôpital bi gayne duñ mo meuna laal fum negani
when I got to the hospital they said they would not be able to attend to me
mo jaar dem police
until I went to the police first
mon ko li ay soldat mako ak ay police
I said to them this was done to me by soldiers police and PI officers
wala numa lifin mo ci suba ci ma jog
the following morning I got up
ñu rahasuma ak ndox ak xorom
my face was rinsed with salty water
ma dem ci clinique bi.
I went to the clinic.
Private clinic.
To a private clinic.
Ma fay.
I paid.
Ñu dress ma.
I got, they dressed me.
Ak suma baram bi sala yaho bi legi.
My finger too, that was where it suffered a problem. It cannot bend.
And then what happened after that?
Ganaw lol nak lana xew
ma dem keur ma dem sun keur.
I went to our home.
Dem sun keur fa lay relaxé.
That was where I relaxed.
Suma time dress joté ma dem dressi.
And when my dressing time comes, I go and have my dressing.
Non la don manager.
That was how I managed.
Ay mo wara dem dressi ma dem dressi. Suma wara gina garab ma dem cina.
Each time I had to go for dressings, I would go and take have my dressings.
Dañ ko ñewon sa.
If I had to buy medication, I'll go out and have my medication. In fact,
man ma til suma loxo ba wer.
They stitched it. In fact, I treated myself until I got well.
At what stage were you at the NIA?
Ban jamano nga nekkon nak NIA?
NIA time bobu ma joge dama joge dressi dama joge dressi ben de.
One day when I was coming from dressing,
am ñari nit ñew suñu kër.
Two individuals came to our home.
You know ma dañ la soxla.
They said to me they needed me.
May lan soxla, you know ma may lan fan, you know ma dañ la soxla.
I asked them where and they said we need you.
Man dama fa woro police la sax.
I thought they were police.
So you know ma no dañ la soxla NIA.
They said no, we need you at the NIA.
Parce que amna ñu la xamé ñu ne yaangi won ci you know ci problème bi in Westfield.
Because there are people who recognized you and they said you were part of the problem at Westfield.
So ma dem ñu jël suma statement.
So I went and they took down my statement.
Bu ñu jël suma statement.
After they took my statement,
so you know legi mën nga ñibi.
They said to me, now you can go home.
So anyway, ñu suñu need you, we'll call you.
Anyway, if we need you, we will call you.
Dama dem nak di report fofu.
I used to go there to report.
Wa di teñu ma fofu nak.
But they did not detain me there.
At what stage did you know that Solo Sandeng was there?
Yo kañ nga xam nak ne Solo Sandeng mu fa?
Kërëk mu fa démé, da dégg Solo yang fa.
That day that I went there was when I heard that Solo was there.
Solo was there.
So, but on this particular occasion, you were not detained?
Boobu yoon nak moom téyewuñ la woon.
Oh, téyewuñ waa, joxe na suma statement.
I was not detained, but I gave my statement.
Earlier on, you mentioned that you were dismissed from the Gambia Ports Authority.
Ci gannaaw nak wax nga fi ne dañ la dakh ci sa liggéey bi nga doon def Gambia Ports Authority.
Wow.
Yes.
I would give you this document to take a look at.
Dama la jox na kayit bi nga seet ko.
You take a look at the document. Can you tell us what it is?
In 2011.
Mune setal kayit bi nga wax ñu lan la?
Ma dismissal letter.
Letter biñ la bindo biñ ma bindoon bañ may dax.
From which institution?
Fan la letter bi bayeko ban liggeyukaay?
Refna admit wa admit la bayeko.
I think it's from the admin.
Admit
la. Admin of which department?
Ferry services.
Admin bu fan la?
Ferry services.
Ferry services signed by who?
Fan moko sign?
It's not signed by the managing director, it's signed by Mariama something Mariama Sar.
Thank you very much. You had provided some pictures to the commission. Please take a look at these.
Jerejef amna it ay natal yo xamne jox nga ko fi commission bi setal yi.
Li suma loxo bi.
Take a look at that photograph.
That's me.
Moy bi ak suma loxo bi ak suma baram bi.
My hand and my finger.
If you look at, can you tell us how long it took for your injuries to heal?
Dañ ñu mëna wax ci ñaan ñaata waxtu wala ay wër la sa gañu gañu bi doora wër.
Jëlna wa 3 months dal maximum.
It took
3 months.
It took between 2 and 3 months. Because it went until the stitches went off. I was going to have it dressed.
If you look at the photograph, you're wearing a coalition T-shirt, and the bottom writings seem to suggest President-elect Adama Barrow.
So said Lord Natal Binak. Yangi sol t-shirt coalition bi te ci souf ci walé ndayjor bi ñu fa bind na président biñ tan Adama Barrow
ma li la solo bes bu mata Westfield t-shirt bi.
Yes, this was the t-shirt I wore that day I stood at the Westfield.
Muta gayd mun ma xame jeen ma mun xame ci bir nit ñi.
That was why they could easily identify me amongst the crowd.
Can you, but that is impossible.
Why lolu mun ta am?
Because the attack on Usainu Darbo and the UDP, the executive, preceded the selection of Adama Barrow as a coalition candidate.
Ndaxte jamono joju Usainu Darbo bañ ko don arrest mo jitu tan bi nga xamne mom lañ tan def ko Adama Barrow mu nek president.
That's true, but that time these t-shirts were in circulation.
You could print.
They were printed.
No, these t-shirts could not have been out.
We were doing the collections, seeking funds to print these t-shirts.
I understand that. No doubt you may have participated in that. But what I am driving at is as follows.
Xamna wediwuma lolou ne xamna yo bokon nga ci waye lima wax moy ne
these t-shirts were only printed after Adama Barrow was selected as coalition candidate.
T-shirt yi bo se bi ngeen ko defar fekkana Adama Barrow ñu tan ko be pare pour mu taxaw ci tour coalition bi.
T-shirt yi gënon na fo lu ñu ko selecté li ñu ko don print.
T-shirts came
in Westfield.
By that time,
as ñu ko don jaay Westfield ci ben boutique.
When he was selected, that was when we printed them. They used to sell them at Westfield.
And that is precisely the point.
Lolu moy mbir mi.
These t-shirts were made after Adama Barrow was selected as the coalition candidate, correct?
T-shirt yi da ngay ko defal gannaaw bu ñu tanné Adama Barrow pour mu taxaw ci tour coalition bi, you know.
Waaw, deug la. Waaye tamu sa Adama ñu ma pour join you. Pour join gaay ñu Usainu gaay ne ko bu yo bokulo.
At that time Adama came to join Usainu Darbo and co, but they told him that he were not part of it.
Ko yo tawel bor ñun we are heading to mile 2.
They told him to stand aside.
Bu ci boka.
We were heading to mile 2, don't be a part of it.
All that is not significant here, but the important thing is that the date that Usainu and co were arrested, these t-shirts were not printed, correct?
I agree with you, counsel.
Lima wone fi moy ne yeb amut solo li ñoo wax ni moy
I agree with you.
Biño arrest Usainu t-shirt yi defaragu.
At this point I agree with you.
Muna wa nanguna.
And also, if at all your injuries had healed after 2 months, then it means to say that the injuries would have healed by May, end of May or June.
Su fekkene nak sa gañu gañu ñu wër nañ gannaaw ñaari wër bon dafa melni mu nga wëri ci wëri May wala June.
Wow, it's my memory can serve me. Wow, lolu mën na nekk.
And Adama Barrow, yes, that was could not selected as head of the coalition before December.
Te Adama Barrow tanuñ ko won pour mu jité coalition bi bala wëri December.
So how do you explain this disparity?
Naka nga muna waxe nak outé bi amni
to muna nek ay mistake to me.
It can be a mistake on my part. I agree with you and I appeal for that. Sometimes my brain, this has affected my brain. And if you look at the writings on the T-shirt, it says President-elect Adama Barrow. It means the elections had already occurred and Adama Barrow was already chosen or was already elected as president, but he's not yet taken over.
Denye president bin tan Adama Barrow bon dafa melni bobu tan nañ ko def ko president way bobu commencé gout
ngala so which means to say that this picture was taken around January in 2017
bon mu melni natal bi ñu ngi ko jël bori January 2017
do you see the problem
what is I do mom dafa gënë bu yaga.
But the T-shirt was out a long time.
When Marcos was on that, anyway.
I was the one wearing it anyway.
I'm wearing it.
The problem I have with what you have said is whether those injuries are in fact consistent with the attack on UDP militants in April of 2016. Because this picture seems to have been taken in January 2017.
Li ma wax ni moy ndax gañu yi mengo na ak xew bi nga xamne wax nga ne mom la mo la dalon 2016 ndax te natal bi yang ko jël ci atum 2017.
No, I don't think anyway. I don't think
All right, I'll proceed. And you were subsequently, after the new government came, did you make any complaint about your dismissal?
Legi nak ganaw bu nguur gu bes gi commencé ndax amna ben tawat boko def ci li nga xamne mo la dal.
Wow. Yes. What complaint did you make?
Yan tawat nga def?
Complaint bi dem ci jobaté.
I went to Jobate.
Usman Jobate. Bo moy the deputy managing director.
He was the deputy managing director.
Sama ben friend mo fa nekkone officer.
One of my friends was there as an officer.
Musa Diouf fa nga xam nga ko Nigawan.
Musa Diouf, I think you would know him, Nigawan.
Kuma mo call.
He called me.
Muna mo fan nga neka.
And asked where I was.
Mane ko ma ngi Banjul de.
I told him I was in Banjul.
Trial nga ñu office Jobate di nga ko fekk.
He told me try and come to Jobate's office, you will find me there.
Ma jël taxi.
I took a taxi.
Ma dem fa.
I went there.
Ma fekk ko fa.
I met him there.
Jobate na ma togal.
Jobate told me to sit down.
Ma tok.
I sat down.
Mune ma legi sa problem bi.
He said to me, now your problem.
Mune ma Musa Diouf appel na ci man.
Musa Diouf has appealed to me.
Degi dañ buga pour ñu reinstate la.
Now we want to reinstate you.
Mané ko su dé lool la lolu jàmal la santé yalla.
I said to him, well, if that is the case, then that is good news, thank God.
Jobate ne ma da nga try nga binda letter apologize.
Jobate said to me that I should try and write an apology letter.
Mané ma try nga binda ko soko bindé.
He said to me, try and write it, and after you've written it.
Mané ma jokko Musa mu isi ko.
He said to me, give it to Musa, he will bring it to me.
Mo ko binde mo call Musa.
When I wrote it, I called Musa.
Mane ko phone ka.
I asked him where he was.
Mo ma ngi Albion Place, di bori Albion School.
And he said he was at the Albion Place by the Albion School.
Mo ben ak kiosk ko phone ka, mo ngi ndewu fofu.
There was a kiosk where he was having his breakfast.
Mo ma so ko fe bokul rek. Di nga gis kiosk bi ci wall bi, wali Albion School bi.
He said as you bend by the Buckle Street, you'll see the kiosk by the school.
Opposite the opposite former Great Alliance Insurance.
Mungi jakarlo at Great Alliance Insurance.
So madam feka for Moose.
So I went there and met Moose.
Feka rendeu.
At that time he was having his breakfast.
Mune ko letter bangi ni.
I said to him, here is the letter.
Mu jokko ko.
And I gave it to him.
Mune ma ba dama nga dem tok baye mako man nako toboto.
He told me to go and sit down and leave things in his hands, he will take care of it.
Mune mom ci Alexi.
I think the following day
or that day
I
was still at them, Chijobate.
That was when he went to Jobate.
And
gave him the letter. I was sitting down, I didn't go there.
So you were subsequently reinstated.
Yes, I was reinstated.
And you were reinstated on Valentine's Day of 2018. That must have been very sweet. February 14, 2018, you were reinstated,
yes,
correct?
Well.
Yes.
Good.
After they gave him the letter, when I went there, Jobate said to me, relax, I will go and face Tambedu.
And what Tambedu was the managing director. So, Jobate went to Tambedu. How many long discourse? How many come off?
Jobate went to Tambedu. I don't know what
suffices to say that you were reinstated on 14
February 2018. That's right. February. 14, 2018.
But prior to this time, you had already made a complaint to the ombudsman, correct?
Yes.
And you subsequently had to withdraw your request, your complaint from the office of the ombudsman.
Wow.
Yes. Because something was pending. Because the case of the GPA.
So like ombudsman.
If it is at the ombudsman,
they cannot decide.
They cannot decide it.
Take a look at those documents. You will see the withdrawal letter to the office of the ombudsman.
Set a key, Imalajo. Letter being a bindon, a poor Nangu Warsa Tawad, Bowja ombudsman.
Ombudsman, the respected letter.
Yes, the ombudsman and
ombudsman
the reinstatement letter.
And the other letter is your letter of reinstatement. Thank you very much. Mr. Chair, before I yield the witness, before I turn hand over the witness to you, I would wish to ask that the following documents be admitted as exhibits.
Chairman bala mala jebal nak sede bi dama bëgg keyit yi ñu duggal ko ci bir keyit sede yi.
That is the letter to the ombudsman withdrawing the complaint by the witness.
Moy letter bi nga xamne sede bi bindon nako office ombudsman di nangu wa tawat bi nga xamne mom la fa yobbu won.
Okay, the first exhibit would be 122A. The one I have just cited would be 122B.
Jekabi moy number bi moy 122A, benen bi moy 122B.
And the reinstatement letter would be 122C.
Letter biñ ko binda nak pour jëlat ko ci liggéey bi mo wara nek 122C.
And the photograph of the witness in which he wore Coalition Gambia t-shirt. That should be 122D.
Benen natal bi nga xamne nak sede bi mum ci natalu te sol t-shirt coalition bi bobu mun na nek 122D.
With that, Mr. Chair, if the documents are accepted as exhibits, I would hand over the witness to the commission for further questions.
Legi nak Mr. Chair bu den nangul nga ñu nak yoy yeb ñu duggal ko mu nekk ci keyti sede yi su boba nak legi mun na la jibal sede bi.
Council mun na dama may ma leral tout ombudsman bu.
Hold on a second. Mr. Job.
Yes sir.
Were you prosecuted?
Mr. Job ndax yobu nañ
la. In 2002.
Attending the 2002.
Taken to court.
You are in the court. 2002.
Okay. Let's deal with these documents first.
Documents first, Emma. Thank you, counsel. Your requests, 2, 3, 4 of them, I think, are granted. The discrepancies that you were referring to, alluding to regarding the photograph, what is the outcome? Are you satisfied that the photograph is authentic in the light of the date discrepancies and other things? Are you satisfied?
I am satisfied that the photograph is authentic, but I am not satisfied that the injuries showed are consistent with his testimony. If the injuries he complained of occurred in April and healed 2 months thereafter, they could not have been the same injuries as those shown in the photograph. Because it's quite clear that these photographs, in my view, were taken in January 2017. So it's either that the witness is mistaken as to the connection between the injuries and the photographs that he gave, or the duration in which his injuries healed. But quite clearly, the witness could not explain away the discrepancies, I leave it to the commission to assess the credibility of the witness on that particular issue. I am under no doubt that he suffered injuries, but whether the injuries in April are those that are depicted in the picture that was taken in January.
Actually, my point was exactly on that one, whether or not that would determine the authenticity of the photo. But if you are satisfied with the other points, I leave it to you to request the inclusion of these.
Yes, perhaps they should be included such that the commission would have a basis to assess the credibility of the witness on that particular issue.
Wonderful. Thank you. Thank you. Council, you may continue. I thought he had some questions for you before we have him, the commission gets it.
Mr. Chair, I have received this document from this witness. Perhaps it is something that we need to clear. I asked him whether he was ever convicted. When you were arrested in 2002, were you taken to court?
Lima Bugalaj said, Abimoy, being arrested at 2002, you were born in court.
I never stood before a court.
Mr. Witness, take a look at this document. It was provided by you.
Settle Kate, being a hamna, you yanu kojo.
Have you seen this document before?
This is a receipt when I was being released. This was what they wrote and gave to me. They said to me, hold it. When I was going, this was what I took.
Who gave it to you?
In mile two.
Mile two.
Did you read the document?
Eyesight is a problem.
I didn't look at it because my eyesight was a problem.
Did they tell you what is the nature of this document?
No,
they told me nothing.
Can we bring the document? The document reads as follows. Certificate of expiration of a term of imprisonment.
Certificate la bo xamne jamono ji ñettiyé won ci prison bi jeexna.
So it says whereas.
Waxna nak ne ci kaw lolu.
Number 96 of 2002.
Number 96 bu 2002.
Lamine Diop.
Lamine Diop
was sentenced to a term of 6 months imprisonment
dañ ko tejjon juroom benn wéré kasso
on the 27th day of May 2002
ñaar fukki fan ak juroom ñaar ci wéré May 2002
and has under part 11 of the Prison Act cap 21
ci ci ko nak loi bunti loi prison yoy nga xamne mom la lim
of 1990
bu 1990
served the period of imprisonment required under regulation 68 of the Prison Act
appa bi nga xamne nak mom lañ ko teralon pour mu tedd ko ci kasso bi tedd nako be jeexal ko ci wali loi prison bi
it is deemed that the remaining portion of that sentence has expired from the 5th of July 2002
mu melni li desone nak ci li nga xamne mom la warona tedd jeexna bes juromi fan wéré July 2002
and it was signed for the commissioner of prisons
kiko sign nak daf ko def ci touri commissioner bu prison
Mr. Diop what this document says
Mr. Diop kayit bi day lim woné
it says that you were prosecuted and imprisoned
moyene yobou nañ la court atenañ la tejj la
and you were prisoner number 96 of 2002
te joxon nañ la number muy 96 bu 2002
and that you were sentenced for 6 months
te ñu ne tejj nañ la pour nga tedd kasso juroom benn wër
and from the 27th of May
ñaar fukki fan ak juroom ñaar ci wër May
and that you have served a portion of that
te amna ci lo xamni tedd nga ko ci
and that was that expired on the 5th of July 2002
te lolu jeexon na juroomi fan wër July 2002
and that is the reason why you were released
tay lolou motax ñu bayyi la
what do you have to say about
lo am pour wax ci lolou
and sul degana li nga wax
kasul I heard what you said
why kayd bi
but this paper
ne ñom ñoko binda
they wrote it
why man suffer my sentence 6 months in prison
but I did not serve a 6 month sentence in the prison
definitely buma ñu gëna onañ ma jox ma li
definitely when I was leaving I was called and they gave it to me
when you produced this document to the commission did you know the nature and content of this document
bi nga jele kayit bi indi ko ci commission bi jox len ko ndax xamone nga li ci bir kayit bi ak lim omba
parce que dafa jaxo suma kayit bi ma indi suma kayit
it was mixed up in the documents that I brought
in my papers ci bir de kayit
the commission would examine this
commission bi nañ ko set
If the prison would issue a certificate of expiration of a term of imprisonment to someone who's not been taken to court and sentenced
so fekene prison bi mom mun naño joxe kayit bo xamne woné na né nit ki teddana kasso be jéxal appa biñ ko appalon te fekka borom musuñ ko yobbu court be yon dan ko
bon that would reflect a fundamental problem in the prison system
ah bon nak su boba nak li problème bu reuy la don ci bir prison bi
but be rest assured the commission would look into this
waye betay comme ñu la digne commission bi dinañ sétlu mbir mi
Mr. Chair I ask that this document also be exhibited
Mr. Chair may sakku ci yow nak kayit bi tamit ñu boole ko ci kayiti CDI
as exhibit 122E
mu nekk nak number 122E
thank you very much Mr. Chair
jerejeuf ci sa
chair dañ ko defur ñom sen own plans
they could have done it for their own plans
why man li on sa fuma sentence
but I did not serve the sentence
parce que prison bi dega do fa
because there's no truth at the prisons
parce que len mère mo ñako freeman
because whatever pleases them they could free me for it
all right thank you counsel and your request is granted also
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Council, and thank you, Mr. Joe, for coming to testify before the Commission.
Jerejeuf Council jerejeuf yow it Mr. Diop ci li nga ñew pour joxe sa cede fi ci kanam commission bi
thank you very much
I'm sorry that you are still suffering from the consequences of the horrific and the massive torture that you had endured in the hands of agents of the state
ngi mitilu nak ci ben tay jafé jafé ya nga xamné ya ngi jankuwante ak mom ngir mitital bi nga xamné tek nañ la ko ci mu ngi baye ko ci ñi nga xamné ño waron téwal nguur gi.
Suffering was quite extraordinary.
Mitit gi mom mitit la bo xamné dal lu doy war la.
Commissioners, if you have any questions, please indicate. Yes, I'm Commissioner Carr. I'll start on the commissioners on the left and the right. And Commissioner Carr, you have the floor, please.
Thank you, Chairman. Man, small question.
My question is a small one.
I want to know when you send an apology letter.
You said earlier on that they had asked you to write an apology letter.
What did you want to apologize for?
Why
got you correct? Speaking of Degana.
If I heard you clearly, what were they asking you to apologize for? When Jabate called me, he said to me, this case, because at that time, when it happened, it was advantage. The managing director that was there, whatever he did, it was not lawful.
I directors from the Fajis, all their executive powers.
There were some directors that took their own executive powers. Even if they wanted to help someone
pour employ ko sa,
to employ him,
why you do accept mom ci bopam mo jël ay omitam len employ ci port bi.
He would not accept. He will choose his own people and employ them at the ports. Someone like Jabate.
Dongo Banjul la.
Is from Banjul.
Very helpful somebody.
Is someone that is very helpful. All the natives of Banjul that are working at the port, he brought them in.
Director of operation.
That time he was the director of operations.
Deputy managing director at time.
He was not yet the deputy managing director at the time.
Dock workers.
When it comes to the dock workers, all the natives of Banjul that are there were brought in by Jabate.
For sympathy with Banjul.
He had a lot of sympathy for the people of Banjul.
So
that was why he said to me,
apologize.
Write an apology letter and just apologize.
For some
to fast track your issue. Because we are all natives of Banjul. What happened to you was a provocation. But you won't say it. After I wrote it,
2 weeks.
It did not take 2 weeks.
Ma togal ñu call ma.
I just sat there and they called me.
Sama friend ma togal.
The friend that I sat with.
Mu nga amé moto.
He had a vehicle.
Mu ne ko please dama drop ports.
I said to him, please could you drop me the ports?
Dañ ma oo.
I'm cold.
Ma duga dem.
I got inside and we went.
Ma dem messenger bi ne ma di sa letter la.
When I got there, the messenger said to me, this is your letter.
Dama signal.
And asked me to sign.
Mu ne ma reinstated nañ la back.
He told me that you have been reinstated. That was how it went.
Man luma munta understand moy su fekene
what I cannot understand is that if at all
yo dañ la togn
the trouble do
comme noko explain
as you explained it
lutax yo nga wara bind apology letter bi lol la munta understand.
Why would you have to write an apology letter? That is what I don't understand.
Ñu mention lu rek ma agree correct.
They mentioned it, so I just agreed.
Te duma muna bañ.
I cannot refuse. It's my interest I was following. I shouldn't have done it. But I realized that if I did not do it,
as an authority.
And that is what they asked me to do as an authority. So I just complied and did it. I just wrote it.
Thank you.
Jerejef.
Commissioner Bojan.
Mr. Diop. Mbenna bala fa tandile la ko ya fa ñamin ko ye ko la ko min be taki
Mr. Diop ma nge mitilu nak bu ba li jafé jafé yi nga xamné ye mom nga jank wantel.
I sympathize with you for all the difficulties that you have gone through.
Rejef, thank you very much.
Mbeñi nen kala kabri dani ke dismiss ye pos nu mun tole
dima la bugga laaj moy balañ la don dakh ci liggey bi fan nga nekkon di liggey.
What I want to ask you is, before you were dismissed, where you posted?
Barajali.
Ah, la dismissal letter falan ko ngaje ko report of intini je ko ibuka somtala do ko la ko alla luaya fo nyami do ko la luaya fo nyami fo wolam bam fo wonte because dismissal letter balan wolaje je ko walatina ye bay malete woko je nyaadi
letter bi nga xamne nak mom lañ binda ne da xamnañ la ci liggey bi liñ fa binda moy ne yow ni nga waron di dem di liggeye do daan dem liggeye je nonu lolou lañ binda ci letter bi ne lolou motax ñu daxala xawma yow nak na nga gisee lolou.
On your dismissal letter, it was written that the reason why you were dismissed is because you were not executing your functions as expected. Is that true? And how do you react to that?
I heard
what she said, but I think if you post someone to a place where he is going to work, where he has no mother or father,
I dem this set post it at Barajali station ferry bo xamne.
You post someone at Barajali ferry station, a post which is
ferry bo xamne ñu luma la daw,
which is only operational on Lumos.
Commissioner Kinte ngi ni da fa dan jar.
Commissioner Kinte is here, he used to cross there.
Commissioner Nick Esima beno gudi,
he came to my room and woke me up one night.
Mu ngi wara jara pour dem Brikamaba.
He was to cross over to Brikamaba
parce que I'm a dead body,
because they had a dead body.
Moko faté mook,
I will not forget that at all.
Sun customer day yana ci fer every time.
So a customer, he crosses with the ferry all the time.
Mom xamna Barajali ni mel,
he knows how Barajali is like.
Barajali da nga tok yoy dafa mel ni taw gudi.
When you sit in Barajali, the mosquitoes come to you like rain.
Moko fanan sax bu baax doko am,
you will not even have a proper room to sleep in.
Sunu kinde no fanan amna lima wa.
Commissioner Kinte knows what I'm talking about.
For a lekka bu correct sa boko fa meuna am.
Secondly, to have even good food, you cannot.
Su metey mi disa ruuma lekka any ruuy.
If this come to the worst, you may have porridge.
So bala nga post nit fofu.
So before you post someone there,
war nga ci accommodation bu wara dal.
You should look on the side of accommodation where the person will stay.
Oy amu fa.
Those are not in existence there.
Fool. Family torop.
It's very difficult.
Abaraka ngelaw ko mo moy ni aje ngey ni nka ye ku mo fo janne bari mam barajal moy malum dalilomi yatina ye dismiss ye dalilomi foko ye dismiss ye ko Hussein Dabo e ka fen commune dia bu ñamin dia ba nata kay to ko ngani si faaje wala na ngey ni nka pour sa sene yandi nin mi yatina kan tay mi ani tay mi fo e manke kinwote.
So gisee ma laaj la lolu moy ne ci sa cadre yi tuddulo fi sax Barajali te dama gis ne yow bi nga wax da nga wax ne sa anda ak ni nga don berale loxo Ousseynou Dabo buy jalla lolu motax bañ daxala te nak ma gis leneen lu outé ak lolu lo xamne ñu ko bind ci lettre bi motax ma laaj la pour nga leral
lolu tam diga la motax ma leral ko ko fofu xamna na yaga lolu tam dina ñew.
That is true, that is why I made it clear to her there, because I know that in time that issue will come up. All of that is just the fight. You post me in the bush so that I'll be far away from
you.
When that happened, did you protest or not? Even if I protested, they wouldn't have listened to me because there was a dictatorship government in place. How could you dismiss someone from work without even giving them a warning letter?
The letter is not signed by the managing director.
And the letter is not even signed by the managing director. What kind of dismissal is that? That is a provocation. If you dismiss someone, use the right procedure.
Thank you, Chairman.
Thank you. Mr. Job, before I give the floor to Lankinte, Barajali is not quite Alabi. You have him, is the home of the former president, and his father, who was a very rich man in that part of the provinces, came from Barajali.
Mr.
Job, you have the floor.
Barajali nak du Alabi de ndax te president ba won fa la dekon te bayam donon nako xamne ko amone alel la momit fofu la faxe ko
wala ñun fa lay ñun facilité ñu amul fofu yeb dañ dan tuddé fofu yeb kër jaf sa dawla la.
All the facilities we used at that time came from the household of Sadawla Kerewa.
Brother Sadawla Alaji Jawara.
From his brother Alaji
Jawara. Very close. Moko jarignon torop.
It's a close friend of mine. We are very close.
Su jege ci fil bi fa ñu ci man tok mi waxtan.
He used to visit me and we chatted.
Daf ma bëggoon personally.
He liked me personally.
Legi sa reka sax su mako bëgge sax daf na ma gudi. Ñewal mané ko man fi mo dekk dafa sori. Parce que ah da nga bam gudi so amé rider sax bu ki topal. Ko sama kinte gi ni amna li mo wax.
It's a place we have even if you are a motorbike.
Man ma dem mu jëw wacha.
The highness
mo. Ko bassi kun bu no lay yow. Da nga jël morceau lahas ko fa. Parce que bu ki ko ngi sé sign of the reflect line dañ la topa.
The motorbike reflector would have to be covered by a cloth because if the highness saw the reflector, he would come following after you. There was a hill there. We had the highness.
Thank you very much indeed for those bookie stories. Commissioner Kinde, you have the floor.
Yeah. Assalamu alaikum. Dina degeural li nga wax watu bobu fofu jafena.
I will stand in what you said during those dates. That place was quite hard.
Why port authority li ñakon moy pour wara tété nit ñi buñu leena yobu fo xamné mengowut ak ñom fuñ min.
What the port authorities lacked at that time was how to help comport those who were being moved to an area where they are not familiar with.
Way ñi nga xamné ñoom dañ leen santa pour ñu dem liggé ak mboloy ci ala bi wala ci kaw gi.
Those that we are asked to work with the communities in the provinces.
Dañ leen lay jangal ba nga xamné dinañ mëna mengo ak ñoom té fekka du nekk problem.
They used to sensitize them in a way that they will be able to cope with the situations when they get there.
Munona wa bena wa Solomon Owens nekona kian karantaba.
I can
Banjul, so it was no.
Solomon Owens who was from Banjul to kian karantaba.
But based on the extension orientation, he adapted very easily until he was going to wrestling matches at night with people, with youths of Karantaba and so on. So that's what is lacking in, I admit that. If you had been orientated properly, you could easily adapt to the situation.
Yeah, so. Misal ci Solomon Owens, mom bim ñëwé yi nga xamné non lañ ko tagaté won dafa taxone bay bim ñëwé hejoon na ci biir askan yi nga xamné fa la nekkon be taxna be guddii sax daf daan dem di sétani boré ak xalé goor yi nga xamné ñom la fa nekkalon deugala yow tamit buñ leen tagaté won nonu di ngon doon mëna tok ci biir fofu
moy deega.
That's true.
Moy deega.
That's true.
Man ma nge metul na lol li nga li la dalon te
I sympathize
lolu feel nañ ko torop
with what happened and we feel it a lot.
Why lena naksa waxtan ak esa.
But one thing in your discussion with the council
waxon nga ñu ne door yu la door ak masse courant yu la mass taxna be ñaka nga sa goria.
You said to us that the torture you endured and the electrocution that you also endured led to you losing your manhood.
Way bobu mu la dalon NIA ben wer nga joge fofu dem prison ñaari wer ya bolé ko ñetti wer.
That happened to you when you spent the month at the NIA and then you went to the prison for another 2 months.
Bila esa laje ndax sa jabar daf la don set ci fiñ la tiyé won.
When the council asked you whether your wife was visiting you where you have been detained,
dengane boba fekaw sa jabar mom demna.
You said at that time your wife had already left.
Munuko muñ.
Wa.
She couldn't bear it.
Li xew moy bim yegé né nekatulo gor motam mu daw.
Is it when she was aware that you are no longer a man that was when she left?
Non la na.
Bañ ma tié.
Wa.
When I was arrested.
Nek detention.
Ah.
And on detention.
Waso amé ay xarit yu bon.
If you have bad friends,
wulan lit ci yoon bo xamné ñoo ñu amul jëkkar yo yaangi am jëkkar.
They lead you on to ways where
yaangi ko fi di waste sa time.
They don't have husbands and you have a husband and they keep telling you that you are here wasting your time.
Lu bari na fi.
We have a lot of those cases here.
So amé ay xarit yo xamné seyñ.
When you have friends who are not married,
yaangi leen def xarit
and you make them your friends.
Seyñ dañ ñaan yaa sa seyñ.
waaw legui liñ la japp motax mu mu dem waye duhut li nga ñaka sa goriya ñaari parce que bu fekke lool la nakala yegge ne de nga ñaka loolu be loolu tax mu wara dem so kon loolu taxut mu dem
was it was a
def la jambu rek japp nañ la jambu na la dem na
was it
waye duhut ne de nga delu ci keer gi mu gis ne munu lo munatu lo dohan mu ne la demal mune man ma dem
was it a result of your arrest that led your wife to leave you or was it after she realized that you are no longer able to function as a man and if that is the reason how did she know that you are no longer able to function as a man because you have not gone home where she could prove that you are unable to perform and then to before she could make such a decision
commissioner do ndure jama jama rero sa
you are making me laugh commissioner what happened to me
mangi wadi re wa agus mo bir hol bi
sa I am speaking and laughing but it's not the way you disturbed me which makes me laugh
na am na information
where she got information
ay jangu bi nga wani
and this betrayal you are talking about is what stands
lima face man
what I face to face up till date I'm facing it
man ko ba ci loho yalla
I live all in the hands of God
na lolu luma wara dal
maybe that is something that was to have happened to me
na yalla lolu tudo ci man
maybe that is what God destined for me
so mu ngi melni dañ la wéjé ci mom bala nga génna sa mom mu daw
it looks as if you were supposed to her before you were released
ko luma la ay bad friends wala amé
just as I told you
in the wrong way
you have bad friends they lead you on the wrong way
okay thank you
Thank you very much. If there are, yeah, Deputy Chair, please go ahead.
Thank you very much, Mr. Diop.
Very much, Ayara.
What I want to know is, you had 24 stitches on your hand.
Lima buga ham moyne nyar fuki nyau nyau at nyenent mom ga am ci sa loxoy.
Did you get the treatment when you were at the police or after you left?
Won nañ la faje bi nga nekk ci police bi la wala ba nga genné
man dama genné sama metit
I went out with my pains
ma dem treat ma bofa
I went and treated myself
so ko gisé holé sa
if you look at it
ko muna count
you can count them
it's okay I just wanted to know whether the police had treated you when you were in the
lima bëggona xam rek moy ndax police fat ñeñ la bang fa nekké
amu ñu sama jot sa
they did not have my time
ñu lu bëggon ma dé fofu
What they wanted was for me to die there.
Thank you. Mr. Job, if you have any concluding remarks to make, please proceed to do so now.
Job, bude am nga nak yeen kaddu yo buga teji mun nga ko def.
Jerejeuf Chairman, mang ko gërem diko santa.
Thank you, Chairman.
Mang gërem commissioner si tok fi yeb.
Thank you, commissioner seated here.
Sumaraga Esa, senior counsel.
My younger brother. The senior counsel
ak ñun togal ñep
and all those he's sitting with
na ngay gërëm press bi fi nekk ñep all of them
I thank the press here all of them
man lima dal
what happened to me
dañ na lool daf ma wara dal
maybe it was something that was to have happened to me
ñaan mako won yalla
I did not pray to God for it
wa hay na yalla li la dogal ci man
but maybe this is what God destined for me
miti na nak
it is hard
wow parce que man lima dekk sumay ram man xamna ko
because what I experienced in my body what I felt I know it
wa na yalla lol la tuda suma ne bala ma de din li dina ma dal
but maybe this is what God said that before I die this would happen to me
I thank God for that santa na yalla ci lolou wa
I thank God for that
why li fi hew fi 22 years
but what happened there for the 22 years
buñ ko nangoti
let us not accept it again
neti won na torop
it was painful
tay
today
santa nañ yalla ba TRRC bi ñëwé fi
we thank God with the establishment of the TRRC
parce ñu bari dañ fa ko ni la fa nek in vain
because many thought this would go in vain
parce que ñun suñu liggéeyu kaasa dañ ko daan ñaawalé sa
because even at our workplace they used to mock us
ay boys am ay lakakat lañ
and these are boys who just talk
wow ba ñu ndongol
these are the boys of banjo
wow no dinañ ñen tej lesson
we will teach them a lesson
wow dañ ñu fi gëna ban yaaya jame
they dislike yaa jame the most
wa ñu farna yaa jame lim def bokami
but those who support Yaya Jammeh and what he did to his relatives and what Yaya Jammeh did to Gambians, all of them, all of it we saw here. We are pleading because they say that we should forgive one another. That was why the TRRC was established. We appreciate it a lot. If someone troubles you, you can forgive the person. You can forgive the person. This is the world. Maybe what happened to you also happened to some other person. But let's pray to God that such does not happen again. That did not happen at all.
22 years, encounter.
Because also what we encountered in the 22 years, today is so nice that all are able to sit and narrate what happened to them. Let's leave all in the hands of God. God is able. Let's leave all in the hands of God and know that this is the extent to which God wills it. Those that did this to me, I have forgiven them. I leave them with God.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you very much, Mr. Job, for your testimony. And again, truly sorry that you had to suffer so much in the hands of the NIA.
Jerejef Mr. Job ci li nga ñoo joxe fi sa sédé ñuy mitilu tamit nak li nga xamné mo la dal ci loxo NIA.
And thank you also for the concluding remarks and the forgiveness that you expressed vis-à-vis your torturers.
Di la gërëmi tamit ci li nga xamné moy cadeau yu mujjay yi fi joxe ak li nga wax nak lu aju ci jéggalanté bi ci ñi nga xamné ñoo la doon mitital.
This ends our proceedings, Summer, for this afternoon. We'll meet again tomorrow morning, 10 o'clock. Meeting is adjourned. Thank you all for coming.
Wow, Chubby skincare did it. Doko sol mu dila taxa all over the place. Ci gatal ñun rek ci chub dara du doy day dess. Not only dañu chub but bu do ni he ñu chubal la ba pare nak ñawal la. Ñaw fim gëna sété nak rek lañu fulé. Ñetti ñaw kat lañ am, am na ñaw kat simple nga xamné you know xopati rek mba def sa tay ba def sa dagit def sa roba amut ben dawme. Am nañ ko xamné mo ño dawmel. Dawme jigen dan am nañ tamit special ñawkat bo xamne ñawi goor rek lañu defal nga bëgg sa his and hers muy korété muy tobaski mba muy ngenté muy taka mba nga bëgg rek you know def sa yëkë bu baaxa baaxa baax dagul bi ñu skincare plus ñu dimbali la tanal la ci fam gëna baxé ndax sa yëk gëna for li ngéné lan xol bi bi takala skin care fi la fu légui entay we not all about skin we are skin care and the plus does come in so many different ways Then chew them sap sap.
Designer Outlet is the number one quality and affordable stop shop for all your needs. Get your evening dresses, suit and ties, office wears for both ladies and gentlemen, beach wears, sport wears, pure leather shoes for men, quality belts, bags, heels for all beautiful ladies, original perfumes, accessories, and a lot more.
find us at Kololi New Road opposite Gerafe Mosque at the Aqua Preacher Station, or call us on 295-3411 or 764-2486. Miss B Designer Outlet. Shop right, look good.
Do you live abroad and want to build your dream home in the Gambia without risking your funds and family ties? Do you want a household name that is trustworthy and efficient? A name that will continue to give you updates on the project from the beginning to the very end with videos and pictures? If your answer is yes, then worry no more. Boss Construction and Asset Management is here for you. If you live outside the Gambia and want to build your dream home, then this is ideal for you. Just reach out to Boss Construction and let's start building the dream home into a reality. With Boss Construction, the difference is clear. We give you value for money. Some of our services includes the following: construction management, building equipment rentals, rent management, purchase and leasing, asset management, and many more. For more information, please contact 282-4945. Better still, send us an email, bossgambia@gmail.com. Or you can also visit our website on www.bossgambia.com. Boss Construction, a name you can trust. Boss Construction and Asset Management, keeping families together.
No, anymore.
Welcome, welcome.
Basically, lot of lala me along is cool, man, that I can really relax.
What a madam?
Yeah, that's
what a madam?
Yeah.
Let me do some balance.
Ah, that's fine. Grand Villa.
Oh man, this is like a paradise.
I know.
I so much love this place.
Yeah, thank you, thank you.
Trust me,
tell
I love
them,
this place. You
can move someone and you're watching one.
Yeah.
Captain Jang, I know what Grand Villa.
I tell you. I love this place. Okay.
Yes, yes. Right.
I love this place, man. Oh yeah.
Ni leftan na kuo keso sotola futama origin dum paradise estate mbaye commandiro ke 7527218 wale futan na website oto www.grandvillaguesthouse.com. grand villa guest house